The Committee of ICT of Parliament, chaired by the Vice Chairperson Nathan Igeme Nabeta, the Junior Division East Member of Parliament, interfaced with the telecom giants MTN Uganda and Airtel Uganda and grilled them over a petition by Kawempe South legislator Bashir Kaziwe Mbazira on the unsatisfactory and unfair service delivery by the various telecommunication service providers in Uganda.
MTN has a security flaw as a company that allows rogue application providers to secretly sign up users to internet services and steal people's data. There is a security flaw that you are not fixing. So people's data is being consumed, and from South Africa, where the company comes from, over 1.7 people in that country are being affected through this scam. Secondly, close to 400 million US dollars is being lost through these scams across Africa where MTN operates.
Of other countries have a very big problem. Vodacom is what intercepts with your networks. Once you reach in my district in Ntoroko, you say welcome to Vodacom Congo.
She's bothering.
So DRC. So you start using the network of Congo, yet you're in Uganda. So it's a very big problem. I know as you're pushing the ball to us on spectrum and whatever you wanted us to push UCC to do for you, but as business interest yourself, you can also do it the other way around to have this done so that we have service for people and at the same time make money.
Telecoms attributed their network inefficiencies and increased drop calls to government's protracted process of approving establishment of towers, which have disabled them from building enough masts to boost network. They mentioned that they are required to get approval from 4 different agencies to construct a mast, which is a tall order.
So one way of improving, you know, the quality is to build more towers. So instead of having 200 meters between the tower, you could say, okay, let's try to put every 100 or 150 meters a tower. And we are having serious challenges through ATC, our tower provider, that we share in common with our colleagues, and I'm happy that they already came to the committee. So to get authorization to build a tower is becoming more and more challenging. There is NEMA, yes, but there is also civil aviation. There are the municipalities, KCCA plus others that have to give their authorization.
They also decried public phobia and stereotypes that towers have negative effects on human health, which have seen some communities resisting establishment of towers in their vicinities.
There's this notion that towers are a health hazard, whereas not necessarily. I have a case in court where one of the landlords sued to claim that his cattle had been affected because there was a tower nearby. But when we presented the report, it was clear that it's not the towers that cause the health hazards. As long as you meet certain standards,
education is a very big key. So if you do not educate them, they will really not understand. And you cannot make these people understand more than we can do.
On the issue of exorbitant internet charges, telecoms told the Committee of ICT that it is as a result of the low volume of data usage in the country, yet they incur huge costs to provide internet to users.
At one thing is that the rate by which we are selling data to our customers is driven by the cost that we incur to deliver that data. Okay? It costs us to bring that 1 gigabyte on your phone, and we are charging you proportionally to what it costs us.
They advised government to find means of making smartphones more affordable to Ugandans by reducing taxes levied on them to trigger down the cost of internet in the country. According to the MD of MTN Uganda, the more users, the more internet fixed cost can be spread out, and the more the cost of data can reduce.
The markets, the more people can get access to a smartphone, the more they will use data, the cheaper the data will become. It's, you know, maybe the chicken and the egg. Do we first need to lower the price to get more usage? We believe that we first need to look at the cost of the device. They are very expensive. They are not affordable. Okay, so before you can talk about affordable data, we first need to talk about affordable device, handset.
You're lacking sensitization. It's more important. I don't know the strategy you're going to use. Why should you wait for people to complain? And moreover, sometimes even making that call, getting to someone to guide you, it's a little bit challenging. You spend more than 30 minutes trying to get online. It is a little bit challenging. Why do you have to wait?
Telecoms have underscored the need to educate the public on data usage, saying many of them have useless applications in their phones, which encroach on their data without their knowledge.